Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'll talk about how to create SQL queries with ChatGPT. Here are the topics I will cover in this video. First, we'll take a brief look at what ChatGPT is. Next, we'll cover what SQL is. After that, we'll discuss basic SQL commands in Python using ChatGPT. Lastly, we'll learn how to work with a database in Python with ChatGPT. Before jumping into the video, don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. Let's dive in. ChatGPT is a language model developed by OpenAI. It is specifically trained for interactions by conversation. You can ask questions to ChatGPT and chat with it. It also can code, fix bugs, write articles, help you decorate your home, and more. ChatGPT was fine-tuned on top of GPT 3.5 using supervised learning and reinforcement learning. Okay. We learned briefly what ChatGPT is. Let's take a brief look at what SQL is. SQL is a programming language that communicates with databases. You can use it to manage and manipulate data stored in relational databases. SQL is a standard language used by many database management systems, such as MySQL and Oracle. To show you how to work with SQL, I'm going to use SQLite. SQLite is a lightweight, open-source relational database management system. Okay. We briefly discussed what SQL is. Let's move on and take a look at how to work with SQL in Python using ChatGPT. It is very easy to create SQL queries with ChatGPT. To work with SQL, let's create a database using ChatGPT. Let's say, write an SQLite query in Python to create a database. Okay. Now, we want to create a table in this database with several columns. After that, add a table named demo consisting of columns such as ID, name, age, and job. Look at that. It started to write SQL commands in Python. This is amazing. As you can see, ChatGPT also gave us explanations of these commands. Thanks ChatGPT. Let's copy these commands and then go to Jupyter Notebook. I'm going to use Jupyter Notebook in this video. Let's paste these commands into the cell. Let's execute this cell. Okay. We created our database and table. You can see this database in our working directory. Let's add some values to this table. Add 100 random values inside this table. Yeah. ChatGPT started writing SQL commands for us. This is very good. Let's copy these commands. After that, let's go to our notebook and then paste them into this cell. Let me execute this cell. It's done. Now let's take a look at these values. To do that, let's go to ChatGPT again and say, write a SQL query in Python to show the first 5 values in this table. Okay. ChatGPT started writing SQL commands for us. This is awesome. Let's copy these commands. After that, let's go to our notebook and then paste them into this cell. Let me execute this cell. Look at that. We can see the first 5 rows of our table. Excellent. Let's take a look at the average of the age column in this table. Write a SQL query in Python to see the average of the age column in this table. ChatGPT started writing SQL commands for us. This is awesome. Let's copy these commands. After that, let's go to our notebook and then paste them into this cell. Let me execute this cell. Look at that. The average of the age column was returned. This is very good. Now let's look at how to work with an existing database. Suppose we have a database called My Demo. Let's take a look at the names of the tables in the database. Write a SQL query in Python to see the names of the tables in the database named mydemo.db. ChatGPT started writing SQL commands for us. Excellent. Let's copy these commands. Next, let's go to our notebook and then paste them into this cell. Okay. We are ready to run this cell. Let me execute this cell. As you can see, this database contains 2 tables. Let's take a look at the values of the EMP table. Write a SQL query in Python to see the values of the EMP table in the database named mydemo.db. Okay. The SQL commands were written. Let's copy these commands and paste in this cell. Let me execute this cell. we can see the values of the EMP table. Beautiful. Finally, let's take a look at the values less than 5,000 in the SAL column. Write a SQL query in Python to see the values less than 5,000 in the SAL column in the EMP table. The SQL commands were written. Let's copy these commands and paste them into this cell. Let me execute this cell. We can see the values less than 5,000 in the SAL column. This is awesome. That's it. Thanks for watching. In this video, we learned how to work with SQL commands in Python using ChatGPT. I hope you enjoy it. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, give a like, and leave a comment. See you in the next video.